Well, today we have with us Shri Dnyaneshwar Mulay ji, who is the senior Indian foreign officer, a career diplomat and secretary for foreign affairs and consular passport and visa overseas India affairs. And we're widely known as the passport man of India. Sir, first of all, thank you for giving your time to 10 News. I would like to ask you first that you have played a key role in bringing the passport services near to Indians and more accessible and convenient. Mm-hmm. And you get the moniker of passport man of India. So how you see it?
Well, I'm very happy if people recognize me as the passport man of India. However, I would like to give this credit to my minister, Shrimati Sushma Swaraj, and the entire team that I have got, because I have about 2,000 people working throughout the country, issuing 70,000 passports every day. We also issue about 250,000 SMSs every day, and our website has a hit of about 20 million, that is 2 crores every day. So it feels nice, but I think we have come a long way, and we have to go a long way. We are somewhere in the middle, and I'll tell you why, maybe subsequently.
Yeah. And from sir, from someone who didn't have footwear to wear in fourth standard, and to being the Consul General of India. So how you feel about it?
Well, this is not my journey alone. I think this is the journey of independent India, which gave, and the democracy, which gave us the opportunity, to educate ourselves. Ours was perhaps the first generation to go to school. At least in my family, ours was the first generation to go to the school. And because there was a school in the village, we could go. They were good teachers. They also, deserve a lot of credit. Simple people, simple parents, but they, taught us good sanskars. And, that's how I came here. So from almost, you can say, very, very rural background, to the highest positions in Government of India. This has been a long journey, but very, very challenging, very, very fascinating, interesting journey, and also with lots of ups and downs. I won't say it was a straightforward journey of lot of difficulties, but also I would say my whole effort was to overcome those difficulties, come what may, and to go to the next stage.
And sir, if I talk about the journey of Indian passport domain now, how you see it, that it's going through several phases, fast expanding networks of passport seva kendras, and there are ever growing numbers of the appliers. So how you see it?
Well, I think we have done a lot of work in the last 3-4 years, and because, as I said, our minister was very keen that we must expand the passport, and it should go to the last person, whether it is in rural villages, whether it is in tribal areas. So we decided to fight this particular difficulty or challenge in two ways. One is, we decided to expand the network. There were about 77 passport offices in this country in 2014. Today, I'm very happy to say that we have more than 350. This is remarkable, considering that we didn't have too much additional funds. We did not have too many additional hands with us. And the resources were meager, and the period was very short. So, number one, we expanded the number of our passport centers throughout the country. And our objective, our aim, is to reach out to every district and, if possible, to every Lok Sabha constituency as early as possible. And I think with the current pace and speed, we shall be able to achieve this particular goal very easily. Now, the other side was making the process simple, making the process easy, making the process efficient and transparent. So for this, we sat down, we saw all the rules that existed on paper, long, difficult, treacherous, and we said that this is not going to help us. Even if you have the passport centers, people will not come to us to get the passport if passport process is so difficult. So we dismantled, we threw away almost the old system. For example, earlier they used to say date of birth certificate, it has to be only by a government organization, like a municipality or a gram panchayat or maybe a corporation. We said no. In addition to that government certificate, even the hospital certificate, the school going certificate, school leaving certificate, all these certificates will do. We don't have to worry too much about that. Earlier it was extremely difficult for single women or divorcee women to get the passport because it was mandatory for them to write the name of their ex-husband. And same was true for men. They also had to write the name of their ex-wife. So we thought it is irrelevant as to who was your wife or who was your husband in the past. Just make it simple. So we removed it. Children of such parents don't have to write the name of both the parents. Earlier it was compulsory to have the name of father, have the name of mother. We have removed it. There was another interesting provision earlier, which actually was made to make people's life easy, but it made it difficult. They say that if you want to have Tatkal passport, you have to go to a government officer and he has to issue a verification certificate to you or character certificate to you. Now, we removed it because we realized why should a common man run after government, some government officer to get a certificate? As long as they have completed the documents, they can come and they can get their passport easily. Another thing, there were so many documents were prescribed. We said, this will not do. Common man, when he will read the list, he will get frightened. Oh my God, mujhe nahi chahiye passport. Aur isi wajah se ek samay aisa tha ki logon ko lagta tha ki passport lena ya lene ki koshish karna, wo Himalay mein jaakar Everest ki unchai jo hai paar karne se bhi mushkil tha. तो वो भी हमने आसान कर दिया. आज के दिन में अगर आपके पास पैन कार्ड है, इलेक्शन कार्ड है और आधार कार्ड है, ये तीन अगर कागज आपके साथ पास है तो आपको ज़रूर पासपोर्ट मिलेगा.
सर, ये प्रोसीजर सिंप्लीफाई करना कितना मैसिव स्केल पे कितना चैलेंजिंग था? बहुत चैलेंजेस आपने सामने फेस किए होंगे, तो उसके बारे में.
बहुत चैलेंजिंग था और चैलेंजिंग नहीं भी था. चैलेंजिंग इसलिए था कि ये सब जो हमने सुधार किए, ऑल दीज रिफॉर्म्स दैट वी मेड और चेंजेस वी मेड हैड टू गो टू द डेस्क ऑफिसर इन द पासपोर्ट सेंटर्स एंड समटाइम्स ब्यूरोक्रेसी इज स्लो टू चेंज. सो वी हैड टू कंडक्ट ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम्स. वी हैड टू टेल देम दैट वी आर नॉट हियर टू कंट्रोल द कॉमन मैन, वी आर हियर टू फैसिलिटेट. दिस इज अ पासपोर्ट सेवा and do that in the spirit of seva. And I think slowly I can say that they understood the philosophy behind our efforts to change. Some of them did feel that their power was being snatched away. Some of them perhaps felt that they could not make money, small money that they used to make. Some people who perhaps indulged in corruption, their corruption route was disturbed completely. So these were the challenges. The other challenges were about manpower, about finance, because in government finance is not a very easy thing. Budgeting has to be done. But with the guidance of the minister, we were able to sort out these issues very, very effectively. And so the process went on smoothly.
Sir, by your own admission, the passport process, how easy has it become right now? And in how many days actually we can get a passport?
I would say that if it is a renewal, it should not take more than 72 hours. If it's a new passport, and if you have these three documents, Aadhaar card, election card, and PAN card, if you have these three documents, you should get it without police verification in 2 to 3 days. So that's a revolution as compared to what it was there. In this particular case, police verification can take place later on. But meanwhile, you get the passport. If you want to travel, there is no restriction on you. Only thing is you should take the care to see that your police verification is completed after you have left also. Because sometimes what has happened is people have taken the passport because we allow them without police verification, and then they don't check whether their police verification was done properly. Then somewhere they're in the foreign country and suddenly they get a SMS from the embassy that your police verification has not come properly, so you please get it done. And then it can put the person to a lot of inconvenience. But apart from that, getting a passport today in 2 days, 3 days is not really an impossible thing. And you can also, there are other things like you can now apply for passport on your mobile. You can also apply anywhere in India. For example, if your passport is issued in Chennai and if you want to apply in Delhi, you can apply in Delhi. Your police verification or address verification will be done at whatever permanent address you are given, but your biometrics can take place in Delhi, so that you don't have to be, you know, present in Chennai to apply for your passport. So these are basic things, but they have made people's life very, very easy.
So recently you told in an interview that in 1984 your mother wanted to meet you in Japan. Yes. And she had to go so many processes to go for the 500 kilometer she has to travel from her village to Mumbai. So was it that inspiration to do something in the passport domain in India?
Sure, I'll tell you the story. My village, where my mother stays even now, is about 500 kilometers south of Mumbai. Now, when I went to Japan as a diplomat, as a representative of Government of India, I wanted my parents to visit me. So I told them to come to Mumbai, apply, and then, you know, come to Japan. But it was not easy. They had to come, stay with some relatives for 4 or 5 days, make a number of trips to the passport office. So I must remember that my parents are from village. They don't speak English or Hindi very well. And they have to run around in a city like Mumbai. So it was quite a lot of trouble to them, even though I was in the service and I had made several calls to the passport officer in Mumbai. So somewhere in my mind, a seed was sown that if I get an opportunity, I will change the system. If I get an opportunity, I would like to see that passport process becomes very, very easy. It should just like happen like this. There is a Supreme Court judgment of 1970 where the Supreme Court has said that passport is a fundamental right of every citizen. So what I have to see as a passport officer or somebody who controls the passport system, that anybody who comes to seek a passport, as long as he is Indian citizen, as long as there is no criminal record behind the person, he gets the passport. And when I say he gets the passport, he should get it efficiently, he should get it in a friendly manner, with a smile. You know, generally government officers and offices are not known to have smiling faces. But I want my passport officers to be smiling and doing the service. And we have seen that the service happens in that spirit. And when my parents came to Japan, I saw that I took their passports and took them to the immigration officer. I showed the passport. And while showing the passport, I saw my mother's thumb impression on it. And you know, it moved me from inside. And I realized that, yes, if you have a passport, even if you're illiterate, you can travel. And there are so many uses. Passport can be used for going to education. Passport can be used to go and visit your parents, visit your children, visit your relatives. Passport can be used even by a farmer if he wants to see Singapore or Dubai, who has never been there, but he has saved money to go to these places. But the fact that passport was so difficult that people thought that, main nahi chahta hoon passport. I thought changing that thinking was very important. Now, I can say with satisfaction that people in India do feel that passport is easy, and anytime that they want to have a passport, they can go to a passport office and get their passport. So I think this is very, very satisfying to me. I'll tell you another story. Sometimes, you know, it just happens, even if you don't know what good you are doing to the society. In Indore, after the passport office there was inaugurated, a few Muslim brothers and sisters came to me. They told me, we don't know how to thank you. I said, what happened? This passport facility is everybody. They said, yes, but we go to Hajj. And when we go to Hajj, that is the only time we need passport. And we were being harassed so much that from here we have to go to Indore, we have to stay there for 2-3 days, we have to spend money on transport. And if one document is missing, again we have to come back to Bhopal, you know, and, you know, get the document, again go there. So this has saved our trips, this has saved our money, and this will also helpful to us, because if we are in our own city, we can always go home quickly, bring that document. Or we can ask some friendly person to, you know, help us out. In an alien city, it is impossible. So this is what has happened. You know, people from Latur in Maharashtra, they used to go almost 600 kilometers to Nagpur for their passport. People from Kolhapur had to come to Pune. So this was the story throughout the country. There were places where people had to travel 800 kilometers. I think in independent India, when everybody aspires for their progress, for, you know, their mobility, you cannot restrict like this. So we have brought change in people's lives. And, you know, that is what really gives me a lot of satisfaction.
I'm sure, sir, there will so many stories regarding this revolution also. I would like to ask you that how you describe this complete turnaround? The hard work and the labor, I know you have done it. Is there any other factor you want to mention?
I think as bureaucrats, as government officers, whether we're in IAS, IFS, IPS, state services, we must remember that we are here essentially to serve the people. The moment we go away from this objective, then we are not fit to be where we are. We need to have people at the center of our work, of our thinking, and the entire life, because we do get our bread and butter because of the people of India. And if we forget this, then we are not going to do justice to our respective roles. And once we know that this is meant to serve the people, it's going to change India for better and very, very in a speedy manner.
Final question, sir. What are the plans of Ministry of External Affairs in boosting the passport services in India?
Well, we would like to see that very soon every Lok Sabha constituency has a passport office. What it really means is people will not have to travel more than 30 to 50 kilometers to get their passport. In fact, most people will be perhaps getting the passport within a distance of 20 kilometers. So our original aim was to make passport center available every 50 kilometers. This will be achieved, and we are trying to do it as early as possible, as fast as possible, despite the constraints of manpower, despite the constraints of finances, and despite other constraints like equipment, software, the local renting of the local office through the postal department. All of these constraints are there, but we are determined that come what may, we will establish these services because they are in the interest of people of India.
Sir, it was an honor to speak to you, and thank you for talking to 10 News. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I would like to thank 10 News also for doing such a wonderful service. Namaskar.